The year was 1928. Herbert Hoover was nominated as the Republican candidate for presidency. Legendary poet and author Dr. Maya Angelou and Apollo 13 astronaut Captain Jim Lovell were born. It was a winning year, it seems. It's also a stroke of genius on the part of S.T. and Portia Kinney, who became the proud parents of Capitola Regina Kinney on August 27, 1928, some 85 years ago. To reach the age of 85 in relatively good health is a blessing and something to be admired. In her 85 years, Capitola has witnessed segregation in this country at its highest levels, growing up in Georgia. But with her parents' guidance and support, she never let where she came from determine where she would go. From Georgia to Ohio, California to Oregon, and North Carolina, Capitola has family and friends throughout the country. And she is a blessing to us all. With 7 children, 16 grandchildren, and 13 great-grandchildren, Capitola has ensured that the bloodline she inherited from Papa and Miss Portia will continue for generations to come. On her 85th birthday, Capitola shares a little history of her life with some of her children. "Well, Mom, here's your family. Just look at what you've done."
Oh, it's so wonderful.
Did you see with
that family? All of them. Children, grandchildren, great-grandmama.
There's a lot of y'all.
And rest in peace, all of those that came before us.
We said,
Hi, we're celebrating Capitola's birthday, her 85th. I'm the oldest of 7. And my name is Joe, as everybody know. I'm going to stop being silly. I love my mama. And this life, looking at these little ones, I can still remember being small like that and just laughing at everything. I was so silly. But time goes fast. I'm so happy we're still blessed with our mother and many more. I hope we bring it in on the 90th, just like we're bringing it in on the 85th. I love my family and I love you. Thank you, Mama.
This is video. This isn't a still video. You can do something. You can act.
Hi, Mommy. I'm your second boy. This is Jocelyn. I love you. I'm so thankful that you have been in my life, all my life. And I'm very happy that we are able to celebrate your 85th birthday. Hey, Virgo's in the house, baby. Love you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I would like to know more about your Bush side, Emma, Ella, that is in representative with Gail. I want to know about Bush Bill. Do you know about that?
Yeah, I know about Bush Bill. I mean, Georgia, like I said, Georgia is where we were. The Kennys, from my father's side of that, owning 200 acres of land, living in a big house, and just going, and my mother did not know her parents. Her parents died in Oklahoma. She was 4 years old. She did not know them. Her grandparents came back to Georgia from Oklahoma because it just wasn't what they thought it was going to be.
And what were their names? The grandparents? Tell me.
Johnson.
Okay.
Yeah. And that was the whole thing. And then the Kennys, wow. The Kennys, like I said, we won 200 acres of land. And they more or less did what they wanted to do. And they had people working for them. What do you call them? Tenants or whatever they call them.
Sharecroppers?
Share, whatever.
Okay.
That's, so we have always, in my opinion, been very aggressive, motivated, educational because both sides of the family, Ms. Bush's parents, the Bushes, I have been told that her dad was one of the smartest men that went through that part of the county in Georgia.
Wow.
And he was a teacher. So her, she and her brothers did not, unfortunately, get the education that her daddy wanted them to have, but, you know, he died.
Right.
And again, her parents died in
the Louise Bond.
Yes.
Charlie Marshall,
yeah.
Noreen,
right.
Butchie,
right. That's Toledo.
Howard, Robbie, Bunkin, Billy.
Now you come
to Canton.
And the only one
I forgot about Laura David.
And then you have.
And then Aunt Ruby.
Sylvester.
Rhonda, Lindsay, and Randy.
Hi, I am Karen. I am number 6 of 7, the third daughter. And I'm here celebrating my mother's 85th birthday. Happy birthday, Mom.
Thank you.
And asking you some questions. Jocelyn was here earlier asking you, and you were talking about being in Georgia and then going to Ohio, and you were talking about the land that the Kennys owned and everything. So what happened to the land?
It's still there.
It's still there, owned by the Kennys?
That's what I was saying. There's one cousin still there. Doug is still living on the land. He and his son are still living on the land. Part of it was sold, yes, when we left. We left Georgia in 1951. Joe was a year old when we had camp Ohio. And they went because of the economy and no jobs and not staying on that farm and working the farm, you know. I know that you guys don't know about working in fields and that stuff.
Okay, when you say, I don't want to cut you off, you say they went because of the economy. What
economy.
Just made just a few go, and then Tom and Doug stayed, go and work the land, so.
Yeah, Uncle Frank, Daddy's brother, still there, was a mechanic, he went to school, mechanic, went home, but on business, and Doug is still living there. We lived there, a part of the problem. We lived, all of us lived there.
So how did Papa meet my grandfather, your father, Papa? How did he meet Miss Portia? How did they meet?
Down there in the country, some blue guy.
I mean,
well, it was an arranged thing.
Oh, okay. It was an arranged thing.
I could say, Mama had her parents, there were three of them. Husband's wife. But for whatever reason, and I have forgotten, that the older people left Georgia way back then, went to Oklahoma. And I am assuming whatever we learned about Oklahoma, I guess the government was giving away land. And people were leaving not only Georgia over and going to Oklahoma because they thought they were going to get land.
Right.
And it's hot in Oklahoma. It's dry. Still is. And they left there and went back to Georgia. And then that's where they were all raised.
And that's where they met, because I know you mentioned also that Miss Portia's parents died when she was young.
They were in
Oklahoma. So who raised her and who arranged their marriage? I guess that's what I'm getting at.
Well, grandparents.
Miss Portia's grandparents arranged the marriage with Papa's parents?
There was a different situation going on there. And I don't think you ever met their aunt, Miss Portia's aunt. Her father's...
Aunt Eddie.
Yeah,
we met her when we went there one year.
Okay. Well, you met her
family reunion,
yes.
And I always said that she looked just like Miss Portia. And that's when you said that's
well,
who raised
anyway,
her.
She more or less raised the kids,
right?
And that was Mama and her two brothers, and there was a cousin whose parents also died in Oklahoma. And that's what I was saying. Those people did not know. what was going to happen. They left to Georgia thinking that the government was going to give them all this money and what they were going to have. Oklahoma just wasn't what they thought it was. And they came back to Georgia, and all of them, even Miss Porsche's grandfather, Grandpa Fed, as you know, he thought, I would say 300 acres of land.
So that was the Kenny's land or the Bush's land?
No, that was, it's not Bush's, Johnson.
Bush, Ms. Johnson. Porsche,
Miss Porsche come from Johnson. The Bushes came out of Atlanta, her father. And that's what I said. Back way back then in the 1900s, when they were going to Oklahoma, the government apparently had offered people or promised them that they were going to get land in Oklahoma. And that's why so many people left Georgia, and not only Georgia, every place there in the top, went back. And they went back to wherever.
So they left their land in Georgia, thinking that they were getting land in Oklahoma, but that did not pan out, so then they returned to Georgia.
No, all that stuff did not happen.
So you're saying that the Kennys had land, Papa had land, and also the Johnsons.
Oh, yes, yes.
So there's land back there on both sides, Ms. Horsha's side and Papa's side.
Oh, yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
And then Jocelyn, you were explaining to Jocelyn about, I believe, when you left Georgia moving to Canton. I may have the story wrong or something, somebody else. Michelle may be able to fill in when she comes to talk to you, but you left going to Canton.
Yeah, because Dad and sisters, Maggie Lee was living in Canton then. They had left Georgia, their husbands left. They had left going to the steel mill. Where they found them, Timpkins, where he was. Republic Steel.
So that's how Papa left, because his sisters left?
Well, they were all looking for a better, the economy was somewhat like it is now, maybe even better. So they went to Michigan, really, thinking they were going to get jobs in the cars, making cars and things. That's where all the cars are made in Michigan. So this is what, well, when they got to Michigan, all these jobs were not available. That stuff, they left there, and that's where there was one of Miss Portia's cousins with Daddy, and one Kenneth. They went there. It didn't pan out. Mm-hmm. But anyway, they stopped in Canton on their way back to Georgia, and of course, Eva and they persuaded Daddy to come back there.
Okay.
And that's the reason why he left there, and like I said, you know, well, if you never worked on a farm, you don't know. But there is land, and half of that land has been sold since we left Georgia. And that's the way it is. But Daddy's one brother, which is, Frank is dead now, but Doug is still living,
still there.
And his son is still living there. On that land. So, okay, now Daddy's mother, Grandma Charlotte, was a school teacher. Okay, I've heard them. Miss Portia would stand up and almost stand her toe because of her daddy was a school teacher. Mm-hmm. And I had many people talking, oh, that's your grandpa? Well, that's the smartest man that ever went through this part of the country.
So was that really? Georgia they were talking about?
Okay. Georgia. And that was Portia's father.
Mm-hmm.
And people there now, you think you're going to school and getting an education. It was nothing like what was going on at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And many people got education, but you know, you had to work for it.
Right.
You had to work to get educated.
Right.
And Miss Portia stood on her heels, toes, and everything for us to go get an education. But from the Kennys and from the Bushes and the Johnsons, what they thought about it, being educated, and going on, and going to the top. That's what they wanted to do. So that's when I said, every one of you, go to school,
do in a family home, basically. And then I was thinking, like, okay, if we're in Luther Francis's house, who was your cousin, Papa's cousin, or whatnot, the black folks, I said, why does he have all the pictures of all these white people? I said, who are all those white people in this picture looking like they straight out of Bonanza? Because they were the old pictures, of course, with him, and that's when she said, those are your relatives.
Oh. Okay.
Right.
Talking bad about your people.
I just couldn't figure out why I was in this colored man's house, as they say, or whatever, this cousin that I'm just meeting for the first time for the family reunion. I believe I was about 16 or 17. That was first time we had gone to that, and we were there in Georgia for that family reunion. So I didn't know. I just went in the house, and it was huge. I know we're talking about the Kennys, but I'm jumping because what I can remember, what I can think of. I'm moving over to Portia's side, the Bushes, and Dot, is that her name? Tot?
Cousin.
Yeah, so she's on the Scotia side, right?
Yeah.
So that land there, and even who was the uncle down there?
Their land was bought from other people.
So they don't own that land. But at one time, that was part of the Bush Johnson land. But they don't own that land. Uncle IT, that was the name I was looking for. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, that's Tot's daddy. Yeah, and she's living on the land now. She lives there.
But it's not hers. It's not the Bush's land.
It is hers.
Okay.
Yes, that's her.
So you're saying that the land was given to the Kennys from the Massa?
They from Olmos and whatever, or them, the whites or whatever, yes.
Right, okay.
And they knew to possess this land. You didn't give it. It's my land now, so that's where it is. Mm-hmm. And the land is for daddy, where he was born, and all of the Kenny things there. Meg sold that a few years before she died, but still in the Kenny family, say 10 years ago or 20 years ago, Meg sold that land and gave it to her brothers, the brothers and sisters and they, of that land, because they wanted to. Okay, now when you think about Grandpa Sam and what he looked like, you couldn't tell him from a hillbilly or whatever, if that's what you want to call it. Mm-hmm. I mean, they were integrated or whatever. Okay, I was told many times, and Miss Portia in particular, okay, you didn't have cars then. It was what you call it,
a buggy. Horse and buggy.
Okay,
so you're saying Uncle Sam was a result of the master going down to the house with the slave girl.
Yeah.
So that's how Uncle Sam came.
That's how his... Well, I was told Miss Portia didn't tell it that way. Well, his daddy was driving the burger, he was there, and the girls were in the back seat back there. And somehow or another, they got together. But Grandpa Sam and looked as much like a hillbilly as he did anybody else.
Okay.
Yeah. That's what he's supposed to be a mix, but he didn't look.
They didn't look.
No, right. No. And then they're just, I mean, it's history down there. It's just knowing
right
who these people. It does not.
Well, Mom, you know, I'm happy to be here with you for your 85th birthday. I love you. I will see you in the next 5 years, because we're going to celebrate every 5 years if we're supposed to get together every 5 years. So when you're 90, we're going to do another celebration. You know, we're going to celebrate each year in between, but we'll have a big party, and then probably the rest of your family will also be here as well. So I love you, and we will celebrate later. Okay?
I appreciate it. I really...
I am the youngest of seven children to my mom here, and I'm going to ask you a few questions about your family history and your family tree. Okay. So we want to know your dad's name.
My dad's mom's name was Shawla.
Okay. And do you remember Charlotte's
birthday? She was a Kenny before she was married, and she was a Kenny.
Oh,
she married a Kenny.
Okay.
And she admit, we
mix.
There's no doubt about it. We are half white and half black. And that's it. And her parents, what I was told by the time I was child and living at it, and Karen talking about the pictures on the wall of the house, that's the way it was. The family was white as far as we were concerned. And that's all I knew about.
And so do you remember, I know Papa's dad's name was Sam.
Yeah.
So his mom is Charlotte, his dad is Sam. And Miss Portia, she's a Bush.
Right.
Her married name is Kim, but her maiden name is Bush.
Right.
And so her dad, you don't remember his first name?
Sam Bush.
Oh, he's a Sam too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sam Bush.
Okay. And her mom's name? Do you remember her mom?
Maddie
Johnson.
Yes.
Maddie Johnson.
Maddie Bush. Yeah.
And you have a sister.
Yes.
There's two of you.
Yeah.
Well, there were three big.
There were three of us. I have a sister that died.
And so you all grew up in Georgia.
Right.
And then you relocated to Ohio after some time because you. So when you relocated to Ohio, you never went back to Georgia to reside.
No.
You just went back to visit. You never went
back to
Ohio. So that's a part of your life that you just kind of got back to.
Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. And, you know, living in, like I said, went to Ohio. There, stayed there all those years, had a family, and the whole thing. But it's something about your history or yesterday, whatever you know, what you have been told as a child, what you can remember, that I told you and what you were told by your dad, all of it, you don't forget. There are certain things that you just don't forget. And you wonder, and like me anyway, well, where did we come from? But now, when I start looking at those pictures that they had, egghead, beaver head, at home, well, these people were looking white instead of looking black. These are my relatives. That's just why I don't know about it. Because of that. Because they were white. And this was America at the time.
So was it ever talked about?
They talked. There are some who have idea, as we all do, who you are, who you were. Oh, so-and-so was your so-and-so. You didn't know who your daddy was? And of course that would be my dad's daddy and those people back then. And especially his daddy. Sam Kenny, my grandfather, that half-white man. Oh, so the story, kids, parents don't tell their kids now anything like that. Oh, well, this song told us, you know, that's a secret about it. Is that right?
So did you know your grandparents, your Kenny grandparents?
Yeah. Okay. Grandpa Sam, again. Living in a part of Georgia in the neighborhood closer to Athens, and that's what you Athens, Georgia is where the home of the University of Georgia is, and this is where instead my parents could not afford to send me to University of Georgia, of course, and at that time they would allow me to come to Georgia anyway, University of Georgia, but I went to a school that's over the hill there, overlooking the Georgia. And this is what you hear. Now, these kids tell stories from whatever, and we intermingle. But now, the difference wasn't supposed to, because I was who I was. Okay. But that part of my parents, Santa, especially from my father, was definitely white. Grandpa Sam was a white man. And that's where we get our color from.
And going to school, you attended what school?
Well,
after
how you're in the country there, whatever. We got a school that was named by the Kennedys. It's our, well, not our school or whatever. But anyway, when I went to high school,
you
I
said
went
it's named
to,
by the Kennedys.
Yeah, it was Kenneth Academy.
And that was the
and that's
for
the school
kindergarten
still
up to
from the, yeah, from the half kindergarten and first grade on to seventh grade. And we went to school there. When I left there, I went to Athens Union Baptist religious school. When I left there, I went to Reed's Christian School, and that's where I went. So
Reed's Christian.
And that.
Did you graduate?
Yeah. I graduated from all the schools, from the business college on up to all. And that's the reason why I think that I am impressed upon you guys as kids and Neva's kids. Go to school, get an education, because our family and parents and things were educated people.
Did you have a desire to go to the University of Georgia, or you just knew that that wasn't something that you wanted?
I would have loved to have done that, but I wasn't allowed that because of who I am, what I am.
So because you couldn't go to the University of Georgia, you opted to go to Union Baptist, or that's just where you
went? Well, Union Baptist Institute was high school anyway. So I went, that's where I went. I went to college. Yeah, I went to Reed's College in Atlanta. That's where I went to, because that's where I wanted to go. I was interested in business. I wasn't all the other stuff. That's what I wanted.
Okay, so do you know when Papa was born?
Yeah, 1908.
Yeah. And Miss Culture was born?
Nine or ten, somewhere like that. Yeah.
And she was 4 years old when her parents went to, or when they passed away. Okay, Mom, so tell me what you know about Black Wall Street, you know, Oklahoma. Because
well,
she said that, Miss Culture's grandfather came back from Oklahoma and bought property in Atlanta, so.
I was about to say, now that I don't know. I would hear Miss Portia talk about Oklahoma and them. Mm-hmm. Well, if you travel through Oklahoma, you know how red the land is there. You just see that now. Mm-hmm. And they couldn't, crops and things, they just couldn't do, it wasn't for them. So that was her grandfather, because Miss Portia's parents were buried there in Oklahoma. And they came back to Georgia, and that's where her grandfather.
Do you know what time frame that they came back?
Let's see, Miss Forshews, I would say being born in 1904, whatever, she was probably in her early 20s. And you remember Aunt Elsa?
I deserve that.
Yes. I think so too.
That's for good. Well, thank you anyway.
Well, yeah. You want to come on?
The girls want you to have a
look. Okay. Just leave it right there, please.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, dear mom! This is Jay Hogan.
Hey!
Hey, what's up?
What part of this do you want, Mom?
Oh, just amazing.
You hear that? This cake is beautiful, girl. We got Virgo in the house, and she is loving every 85 second of it.
All 85 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay, Mom.
Wow.
What kind of
cake is it?
It's a lemon.
Okay. Hello, Grandmother. I love you so much. I wish that I could be there with you, but I'm so happy to know that everybody is there and that they're able to celebrate with you and show you how special you are and how much you are loved because you are. Thank you for being such a wonderful example of what it means to be a woman, a strong woman. And a mother. Thank you. I love you. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Happy birthday. Thank you.
Oh, damn. You made us all cry.
Yeah, I don't think anybody else can say anything.
Right.
Appreciate it very much.
I love you. Yes.
Thank you very much.
And
I love you, Mom. Okay.
Becky and Bob and everybody.
Grandmother is like, she's one of the most strongest women I ever met.
Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, like, seriously, I never met anybody else stronger than her.
Ooh.
And she always wears nice dresses. She always has nice something to say about the day.
Thank you.
And I love her so much. And thank you, Grandma.
Keep your
You are so welcome.
Happy birthday, Mommy. This is Jocelyn. I'm so glad that you've been in my life, all my life. And I'm ready to eat this cake. So I'm glad you came.
And I like it when you like the dessert too.
Show the tea party. Right there in the middle. Thank you very much. Thank you for being our mommy.
Thank you.
Love you.
Happy birthday.
Oh,
sorry, Joe.
Hey, I'm burnt. I'm stuck.
Karen. I love you, Mama.
Oh, happy 85th birthday.
Oh, stop crying, girl. Stop crying.
Stop crying.
Happy birthday, Mama. Love you.
Love you, too.
Thank you for everything.
Oh, man.
You never know what's going to come out.
That's right. Never know.
Yeah,
when you were sitting there in the hospital yelling and screaming, damn. Who knew? All these years later.
And we love and appreciate you.
I know you were cussing us out then.
Sure were.
And I would say more, but I'm getting misty.
Oh, man. Okay. Karen, which
part? Aren't you just
Let's see.
Yeah.
That's what happened when you get a birthday, remember? When you say, oh, wow, birthday.
And it's yellow.
Even me. Even when you get old.
Oh, my gosh.
Look what it says. Happy 85th. Love. Becky. Isn't that sweet? That's Becky. See? How is she?
And Drew and Kennedy. And me. And
Peter.
Paul and Jacob.
Paul and Jacob. Oh, really?
Oh, look at
it matches her blanket.
See, I got a
her picture, her
and it's so pretty.
That's fantastic. You can tolerate it.
Wow, this is gorgeous.
This is not, it's still partly incomplete. This is my pillow in here. I will exchange it out.
Okay. If you
I have not gotten a pillow. A pillow form. So you'll just have to babysit my pillow with your pillow.
Oh, let's see what's in the middle.
Girls, look what I got. This is really pretty.
Want to hold it up so Ricky can film it all out?
It matches a quilt.
Yes.
From our neighbor. Yeah. Oh, this is gorgeous. 2013, all right.
Yes, indeed. And she remembers this yellow.
I don't know how. It's so easy because it's my favorite color, too.
Really? Yes. Yellow is your favorite?
Yep.
Oh,
I don't know. Every once in a while, the name comes to my.
All right, here we are. Our friend Becky and Bob were gracious enough to open up their house so we could celebrate our mother's 85th birthday. My two boys, James and Peter, are behind me. I'm the oldest of seven that Mom's had, and we're carrying on the tradition. Happy birthday, Mom. And off we go.
Hi, Mommy, we are on. We're wrapping this up. I'm Jocelyn, the second oldest. Your two are not here. My two, excuse me, Latif and Patrice. That's okay. We are still part of the second generation.
That's right.
We can look at this when you turn 95 and see how many. Love you, Mommy. Happy birthday to you. This is Kennedy, Portia's daughter. This is part of the fourth generation. Here we have Drew, Leslie's daughter, granddaughter to Michelle, part of the fourth generation. All here for Big 85 for Miss Capitola. Mommy, Big Mama, love you. She Big Mama on the first generation.
And of course, you would have to come to me when we're cranking up.
Of course.
Happy birthday, Mom. I'm Karen. And She might forget by the time. She might not know by the time she's 95. Anyway, I'm Karen. I'm her second daughter, number 6 of 7. This is my oldest son, Edmund. This is my youngest son, Jordan. And I have a daughter, Debrion, as she sang earlier. Mom, happy birthday. We love you. And we'll see you the next time around. Love you.
Hi guys, I'm Michelle, and I'm the seventh child, third daughter, and I have two babies.
Okay.
I have Leslie here with me. I have one more, Courtney. She's not here, she's in New York. This is Leslie's daughter, Drew, my only grandbaby, granddaughter. Mom, happy birthday. It's good to be here with you to celebrate 85 whole years.
Wow.
And in Jesus' name, we'll celebrate many more.
Right on.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Love you.
Right. Love you.
I'll record this. Who is the best? The one that's on the camera who's not in the picture. Well, here I am.
Ricky.
I am Ricky, Alfred Ricardo, better known as Ricky, because half y'all Negroes don't know who I am if y'all don't say Ricky.
Oh, go back to sleep.
Kennedy is Ricky's granddaughter. Yes. Raise your hand, Kennedy.
AKA Papa.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Who's your mommy?
Portia.
She's so dry.
Portia.
She's so dry.
Okay. The mother of all of you at the 85 years. What a story. But oh my gosh, coming out of those cotton fields down there in Georgia. And now here I am with all these kids and grandkids and great grandkids.
Wow.
I love each and every one of you. Thank you. It's a miracle I'll be around for 85 more. But whatever the amount is, I am very, very thankful. Thank you.
Amen.
Love you, Mommy.
Right on. It's all right. Yay! Thank you, Father, Becky. We really enjoyed ourselves.
Can you see him over there?
Thank you for all
the time. That's my husband, over there.
That's Keith sitting over in the background.
Okay. Can you see everybody? Okay. Tanisha, come on. Come on,
Tanisha.
I love all y'all.
Jingle all the way.
Hey, hey, hey.
Oh, the fun is to ride.
on this.
Well, Capitola, that's it. Your family, friends, and loved ones. Happy 85th birthday, and we hope to be doing it once again next year. Same time, same bat station, same location, perhaps. Goodbye. We love you.